In this video, we're going to look at turning this, and you can strum this all the way through, into this. Hi, I'm Joe, and welcome to the channel. If you're new here, please consider subscribing below. We're doing a whole series of videos, so if you also ring the bell down below, you'll be notified when the next one comes out. In this series of videos, we've been looking at chord combinations, two specific chords that I've been teaching you the shapes of, and then giving you a practice exercise to switch in between. In this video, we're going to look at the G major and D major chord. This video is broken down into four parts. First, we'll review the G and D chord shapes. Then, I'll play a musical example using those shapes. And then we'll break down each individual song part so you can see exactly what I'm playing on the guitar. And finally, I'll give you some practice tips. Let's get started. Before we get to the musical example, I wanted to show you the two chord shapes that we're going to be using in this song. It's going to be the G major and D major shape. And these shapes may look familiar to you if you've been watching this series. We've learned these chords in different videos, but this is the first time we're combining them and putting them together. The G chord looks like this. Second finger on the third fret of the low E string. Your first finger on the second fret of the A string. Then you have a set of open strings, which is your D, G, and B. And then your third finger will go on the high E string on the third fret. So all in all, the chord sounds like this. An alternative to this is taking the same shape that you have here, but now take your third finger and move it up one string on the third fret now of the B string, and where that finger was, put your pinky down. So now your pinky is going to be on the third fret of the high E string. That sounds like this. And an alternative G chord, you can also take your first finger and lift it up, and make sure you slightly bend your second finger so it mutes the A string now so nothing comes out, and you can strum this all the way through. Now the D chord. The D chord is going to start with the open D string, your first finger on the second fret of the G string, your third finger on the third fret of the B string, and your second finger on the second fret of the high E string. So that sounds like this. Let's go ahead and listen to the song now. There's two parts to this song, and for the first time in this series of videos, actually the first part has two different sections to it. So let's first go over that. The first section of part one uses the D shape, and we're going to take that shape and actually move it up the neck to make a G chord. So if we remember our D shape, if we slide it up now where our first finger is on the seventh fret of the G string, our third finger is on the eighth fret of the B string, and our second finger is on the seventh fret of the high E string, just those three strings, we now have a G major chord. All this part is doing is playing this D chord shape, but now as a G chord, and moving the pick from the high string back down towards you. And all we're gonna do is take this same exact shape and move it up to the D up here, which is an octave higher. So on the guitar, from the 12th fret down, it repeats. So if we put our first finger on the 14th fret of the G string, our third finger on the 15th fret of the B string, and our second finger on the 14th fret of the high E string, we have a D chord again. So again, this shape just moved up. And again, the same thing. We're going to rake backwards. So the part kind of goes like this. Slide up to the D, and back down to the G. Now the second half is the same exact movement, but instead of doing those individual notes, we're actually going to do an eighth note pattern, playing the full chord. And it goes like this. Up to the D. And all an eighth note pattern is, the song is in 4/4 time, which means there's 4 beats per measure of music, and the quarter note gets 1 beat. If we take that quarter note and cut it in half, we have eighth notes. So quarter notes we count as 1, 2, 3, 4, and eighth notes we count as 1, 2, 3, 4, and. And that's all the pattern that we're doing here. Instead of going 1, 2, 3, 4, we're doing eighth notes. 1, 2, 3, 4, and. And then sliding it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, and. And that's all there is to it for the first part. Now let's look at the second part of the song. For the second part of the song, we're going to stay back in our first position where we learn these chords and basically play full chords. So, the first one is a G. And then, what we're going to do is work our way back on the top E string to the middle G string. So it goes like this. And then go to the D chord. And then we're going to do a D sus 4 chord like you learned in one of the previous videos. You're going to take your pinky and put it down on the 3rd fret of the high E string. Play that twice. Then take it off for the normal D chord. Back to the G. So the second part up tempo goes like this. That's all there is to the second part. Let's go ahead and move over to the practice tips. So let's talk about what to practice. If you're new to these chord shapes, first get the G and the D chord down underneath your fingers, and then practice switching between the two. But the real magic in this lesson is moving your hand up and down the neck. Take that D chord shape, move it up so it makes the G chord, and then move it up the octave so it makes the other D chord, and practice moving your hand up and down the neck from those positions. What's nice here is you don't have to think a lot, you're taking the same exact shape, you're just moving them up. But it's so good to get familiar with doing this. What happens is, on the guitar, if you notice, that the frets get closer and closer together as you get higher up the neck. And sometimes our fingers don't feel as comfortable as they did when they're in the big open position down here. So I want you to start practicing getting the movement down and also adjusting your fingers accordingly so you can get those chord shapes to sound nice and clear. As you get more and more familiar with moving your hand up and down the neck, maybe start to make your own patterns. Start with the D chord, then go to the G chord, jump up the octave, jump back down to the lower D chord. Just have fun with it, but make sure you're practicing to a steady beat so your rhythm gets solid. Also, of course, you can download the backing tracks that I have for this video from my website for free and practice along with that so you can get familiar with moving your hand up and down the neck. But I just want you to start experimenting. That's what's kind of cool about these chord shapes. Now you can start using them and putting your own pieces together to come up with your own ideas. So be creative, try new things. Don't just get stuck in one position. Try to see how these chords sound in different areas of the neck. You might be surprised and you might come up with something actually really unique. That's all for this video. If you found any value in it whatsoever and liked what you saw, please do me a favor and support the channel for free by subscribing down below. Hit the like button and knock on the bell and you'll be notified when the next video in this series comes out. Until next time, I'll see you later. To come up with your own ideas and express your own individuality through the instrument.